And you decided to do something showy, took your eyes off of what was happening, and let Charlotte blindside you.
I'm sorry. I won't let it happen again. I got carried away.
You did. Remember, you're here because you're good. And you could be great. I wouldn't have any patience for Justine's brat, no-talent niece. But don't expect everything to come all at once. You could have gone out there and had a solid match, and that would have been enough, win or lose. But you bit off more than you could chew.
Maybe you're right.
Of course I'm right. I'm a WWE legend. I'll do my best at damage control. You're already off to a rough start with management. They weren't thrilled that you decided against wearing the tribute gear. Although, maybe I can spin that, since it wasn't exactly the performance they would have wanted to be associated with Justine's legacy. Actually worked out for the best.
Nope. They'll just associate it with little old me. I've already seen the chatter on social media.
Great. You're worried about social media at a time like this?
What was that about? I like to show off as much as the next person, but that was embarrassing.
Sorry. I understand why you're upset, but
You grew up learning from one of the most talented WWE legends in history, and that's your best? I did a better job teaching myself in my backyard.
Did you hear that pop?
What? The sound of my ankle popping or my career imploding?
Oh, how is that ankle? Or more importantly, how's that ego?
Ankle's okay. Ego? That's another story.
You really went for it out there, huh? Didn't hold back?
The WWE Universe knows I'm related to a legend, and I wanted to make my own mark, but I got carried away. Shouldn't have done that.
I've had enough coulda, woulda, shouldas to last me multiple lifetimes. It's not worth your time to live in the past. I wish I was medically cleared to fight. I would have decked Charlotte Flair for you.
What was that you just finished saying about the coulda, woulda, shouldas?
Oh, shush. One of the few perks of having a career-ending injury is getting to ask my niece to do as I say, not as I do. Since I, you know, can't.
Right.
Listen, I don't want to leave if you need to talk, but I got word that WWE management wants to chat before we head out. Something about the buzz online, whatever that means. You okay?
If anyone taught me how to be resilient, it's you. I'm fine. I'll talk to you later.
That's my girl. I'll find you in a bit. But what people forget is that for someone to win, someone else has to lose.
It is better to win, though.
Of course. Actually, speaking of winning, I have a few developments that Ruthless Digressions listeners will be thrilled to hear about.
Oh, care to share with those listeners or your co-host?
Like I told my niece at Survivor Series, patience, Robin, patience.
LJ, welcome to SmackDown. How you doing?
Yeah, not the debut.
Well, you're here now and have your whole career ahead of you. Listen, I may just be a cameraman, so I can't help train you, but I've been with WWE long enough that I pride myself on knowing how things work around here.
Thanks, Tom. I think I have the...
Fantastic!
Hey! Welcome to SmackDown.
Thanks. You know, after what Liv said at Survivor Series, I wasn't...
Oh, you won't be. But I have a different perspective than the rest of the girls. In fact,
I'd like a championship someday, but I plan to put in the work...
You're so funny! Someday, if your huge mistake at Survivor Series is any indication, I'll be in the Hall of Fame.
I think we're done here. So, I know I didn't exactly get the best start, but I've got my head on straight now and I'm ready to go.
That's great to hear.
What do you have for me tonight?
Now, here's something that's less great to hear. WWE management thinks that after everything that's happened, we should take a beat before we put the spotlight back on you.
Don't worry. I took your advice to heart. I'm okay with starting small, out of the spotlight. I'm not expecting to main event right away.
Good, because you won't be. I'm going to level with you. Backstage sentiment is not good right now. You may be a SmackDown superstar, but you've got an uphill battle if you actually want to be on the show.
So my match tonight is...
non-existent.
Ah. What can I do? I don't want to just sit in catering.
No one does. But this will all blow over. My advice until then? Find some way to make an impact. Be so good in the ring that they can't deny you.
How am I supposed to do that if I can't get a match?
I said I couldn't get you a match on SmackDown. There are other opportunities to wrestle. Actually, I can pull some strings and get you on main event. You'll need to find an opponent, though. Most of the roster is pretty busy with commitments on SmackDown, and I don't have time to play matchmaker.
Pretty busy or pretty mad at me, from the sound of it?
Yeah, I may have heard those rumblings. Although, have you met Ava Moreno yet? She's pretty new to SmackDown, too, and also would have something to gain with a good showing on main event.
We've met. I'm not sure she wants to work with me.
Neither of you have to work with anyone. You just have to show up and fight each other. Get her to agree to that, and I'll set up the match. If there's some sort of beef between you two, lean into it. No one said the match had to be friendly.
Well, if it isn't little Justine. I would say I'm sorry how your big debut turned out, but I don't like to lie. What do you want?
Let's cut to the chase. I want a match on main event. Molly said she can get me one if I find an opponent. It sounds like getting that exposure could help both of us. Are you interested?
Sure.
Great. That was actually easier than I thought.
Oh, but let me be clear. I want a match on main event, but not one against you. I want to make an impact here in WWE and make my matches count. It doesn't help me at all to defeat some jobber.
What did you just call me?
If I wasn't perfectly clear at Survivor Series, I like people who've come up the right way and paid their dues. Not nieces who get handed special treatment because of what family they're a part of. And if that wasn't enough, I certainly don't like you after you proved me right and made a mess of things.
Regardless of what you think of me, I don't see how just sitting around and complaining is going to change anything.
I know as well as you do that no one else in the locker room is going to help you. You want a match with me? Prove that you have what it takes when you have to work for an opportunity. Pay some dues and stop waltzing around expecting special treatment.
I don't waltz.
We can agree to disagree, LJ.
What's up? I was actually hoping to see you around here.
You were?
Yeah. I loved watching old clips of your aunt on the network when I was growing up. But it was so cool when you debuted at...
Would have been cooler to win. What are you doing at SmackDown? NXT 2.0 doesn't take up enough of your time?
Just doing some photo shoots and a little press. Honestly, it's been nice to be backstage at a show where I don't have to keep a lookout for toxic attraction. Not that I can.
Want some help?
If you're offering, yeah. Honestly, I think they're just jealous. They may be hot and talented, but they could never do what I do. For one, they'd fall off the skateboard.
Not at all. It's not like I'm spread too thin with all my magic.
The following is a tag team match set for one fall. Introducing first, from New York, the Superstar. And her partner, from Chicago, Illinois, Cora Jade!
Come on, let's go! Let's go!
Gigi Dolan and JCG, Toxic Attraction!
Go! Get up!
Yeah! Go get him! Thank you.
Gigi Dolan and JCG, Toxic Attraction!
Are you flying out for some exciting mocap action?
I am.
This is going to be awesome!
Sorry you have to settle for getting...
Sure, but you'll be doing all her moves.
Why would I be doing all...
Because you're doubling for her? Did nobody tell you? Awkward.
I don't want to make a great Justine. I want to make a great me.
I hear you. I guess they just think...
I get it. It's just not what I thought I
Don't
was...
Don't worry. It'll be fun. We'll get out.
I respect the effort.
I hear the powers that be are conspiring.
I don't think I would say anyone is conspiring.
You call it proving yourself. I call it fighting the powers of the malicious arm.
Thanks.
I've got some good news.
You've actually got a match.
Actually,
wow,
I should clarify. It's not on SmackDown, but at a non-televised live event. Dana Brooke.
A match is a match, and if it helps...
Winning the match would help you gain...
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making her way to the ring from New York, the Superstar. Here is your winner, the Superstar!
Come on.